Hi everyone! With the Simulink 2021 version, it is now easy to take the uncertainty of the population parameters into account. If I import a Monolix project, in addition to the elements which were already created automatically, new population parameter elements appear here. MLX Pop Uncertain Lin and MLX Pop Uncertain SA hold the information about the estimated population parameters as MLXPOP, but also about the uncertainty, which have been estimated in the Monolix task standard errors. Depending if you have run the task with the option use linearization or without, which is using the stochastic approximation method, you will see in Simulix MLXPOP Uncertain Lin, MLXPOP Uncertain SA, or both if you have run the task twice with and without the linearization option. We will show in a future video what is exactly contained in these elements. Note that these elements are only created if you import a Monolix project which has run with the 2021 Monolix version. This is because in previous versions the uncertainty information was not saved in the format readable by Simulix. In this video, I will show how to use these elements with two examples. In the first example, I have fitted a complex QSP model without any inter-individual variability to average data in Monolix. The estimated population parameters have quite a lot of uncertainty, up to 50% for some of them. I have exported this project to Simulix and prepared a simulation to check different dose levels from 1 mg to 30 mg in different simulation groups. We will output the target occupancy, which is a surrogate for the efficacy. As I have no inter-individual variability, I will just simulate one individual per group. If I would simulate more, they would just be all the same. Let's first check what happens if I use MLXPOP. In this case, Simulix will use the population parameters estimated by Monolix, these values here, which have been exported to Simulix and are present also here. Simulix will then sample one set of individual parameters, which will be the same as the population parameters as I have no inter-individual variability. If I run this, in the plots, I have a single simulated curve per dose group. As my estimated population parameters are not completely certain, I would like to see where these curves could be given the uncertainty of each population parameter. To do this, I need to select the element MLXPOP Uncertain Lin. With the current setup, I will sample one set of population parameters from the uncertainty distribution, which is not enough to really see the impact. So to sample several, I need to choose several replicates. This can be done here. Now Simulix will sample 100 sets of population parameters from the uncertainty distribution, and for each set of population parameters, we will set the individual parameters identical to the population parameters as I have no inter-individual variability. After running, in the plots, I can now see a prediction interval which corresponds to the uncertainty of the population parameters. We can see that even if we add up to 50% uncertainty on some parameters, at the end the percentage of the target occupancy is in a quite narrow range, around 10% occupancy. If I also look at the individual output, by default Simulix shows only the first replicate. But if you go to the settings display, you can choose to display more, either just a few of them or also all of them. But be careful of the amount of data to show. If it is a lot, the plot will take long to update. Okay, in this example, we had no inter-individual variability. Now let's consider a second example with inter-individual variability. In the second example, I have used a Monolix run with a simple PK model with parameters K, A, V, and CL, with inter-individual variability on V and CL, but not on KA. I have estimated the population parameters and their uncertainty. And then I have sent this project over to Simulix, where I have defined a simulation with a 10 mg single dose. I have set three replicates and two individuals per replicate, using small numbers just to show you each sampling step by step. Let's first recall what happens if I use MLXPOP, the population parameters without uncertainty. In this case, for each replicate, the population parameters are the same, identical to the values estimated by Monolix. For each replicate, Simulix will sample two sets of individual parameters, sampling from the distribution defined by these parameters here. And in each replicate, the individuals are different. Now let's see what happens if I use MLXPOP uncertain assay instead. In this case, for each replicate, Simulix samples one set of population parameters from the uncertainty distribution, and I can see here that the values are different for the population parameters for each replicate. And then for each replicate, two sets of individual parameters are sampled from the distribution defined by these values here. Because Ka has no inter-individual variability, I can see that the value of Ka is identical to the Ka pop, and same here. Going back to the GUI, if I run this project, the individual parameters are shown in the graphical user interface for all individuals and all replicates. To see the sampled population parameters for each replicate, I need to go to the result folder, and then in simulation, population parameters, here. And in the plots, the prediction interval takes into account all individuals of all replicates. So it shows the impact of both the inter-individual variability and the uncertainty of the population parameters. So in short, replicates are associated with the sampling of the population parameters from the uncertainty distribution, and the group size is associated with the sampling of the individual parameters from the population distribution. In the next video, we will show what is exactly the information contained in the MLXPOP uncertain element and how the sampling is done, and then how to interpret the endpoint distribution in case of a clinical trial simulation with a limited number of individuals with and without uncertainty, and finally, how to take into account the impact of the population typical parameter uncertainty but without the inter-individual variability, so to have the omegas equal to zero. Have a nice week!